Hello student, in last lecture I taught you human reproduction and different part of male reproductive system. Today I will explain each part of male reproductive system. So you have watched these are the part of male reproductive system: testis, vasa deferentia, ejaculatory duct, urogenital tract, penis. And these are the glands present inside of the male reproductive system: seminal vesicle, prostate gland, vulva, urethra gland. So in male reproductive system, the male reproductive system is located in pelvis region. Pelvis region means the blue side of the abdominal cavity. There is peritoneal cavity present inside of the abdominal cavity. So lower region of the abdominal cavity is called pelvis region, right? So this male reproductive system is situated in the pelvis region. It includes a pair of testes along with acellular duct like vasa deferentia, epididymis, and glands, and external genitalia. External genitalia means external part of male reproductive system. The testis the testes are situated outside the abdominal cavity within a pouch. It's called scrotum. So you have watched this pouch-like structure. This is cutaneous pouch-like structure which is situated below to the abdominal cavity and in between both the thigh. So this pouch-like structure is called testis, right? It's called scrotum. Scrotum help in maintaining the low temperature of testis, 2 to 2.5 degrees centigrade lower than normal internal body temperature necessary for spermatogenesis. So you have watched the temperature of the scrotum is lower 2 to 2.5 degree centigrade from the body temperature. How is it possible? Due to the presence of testes inside of the scrotum. So scrotum keep the testes away from the body in summer season. So the temperature of the scrotum below near about 35 degrees centigrade. And in winter season the scrotum size is decreased, then after they come in the contact with the body, then after the temperature remain 35 degrees centigrade, which is required for the spermatogenesis. So size of the scrotum can be increase or decrease. It helps in the maintaining the temperature of the body, which is required for the spermatogenesis, means sperm formation. In adults, each testis is oval shaped with a length about 4 to 5 centimeter and width 2 to 3 centimeter. So you have watched this is oval structure, and the length is 4 to 5 cm and width 2 to 3 cm. The testis is covered by a dense covering. This dense covering of the testis is called tunica albuginea. Tunica albuginea. And each testis has about 250 compartment called testicular lobules. So you have watched in this structure the very small lobules like this type, like this is outer dense covering of the testis. This is called tunica albuginea, and it is divided very small, near about 250 chamber like structures. Each structure is called testicular ocular lobules. Okay. Each lobules contain 1, 2, 3 highly coiled semiferous tubules. So each lobules contain 1, 2, 3 highly coiled semiferous tubules in which sperms are produced. These are the semiferous tubules. Where the formation of sperms take place. Each semiferous tubule is lined on its inside by two type of cells called one male germ cells, spermatogonia and Sertoli cells. So you have watched when you will watch the structure of semiferous tubules. So the inner wall contain two type of cells. See, these are the spermatogonia or sperm germinating cell, and these are Sertoli cells, right? So each semiferous tubule is lined on its inside by two type of cells called male germ cell, spermatogonia and Sertoli cells. Male germ cells undergo meiotic division, finally leading to sperm formation. So these spermatogonia cells and sperm germinating cells participate in the meiosis division, and they are diploid and they form 4 haploid sperm, right? And the Sertoli cells provide nutrition to the spermatid and convert to the sperm. So while Sertoli cells provide nutrition to the germ cells, the region outside the semiferous tubule is called interstitial space, where contain small blood vessels and interstitial cells or leading cells. And this space, this line, wall line, it contains blood vessels and some special term nerve fiber or some special type of cells, interstitial cell or leading cell. Leading cells synthesize and secret testicular hormone called androgen. So this the wall of the lobules contain one special type of cells. They are known as interstitial cells or leading cells. These interstitial cells or leading cells secrete androgen hormone, means testosterone is a type of androgen which help in the formation of sperm, and it is also responsible for secondary sexual character in male, right? Other immunological competent cells also present. Some immunological competent cells also present in the wall of lobules. Next, the male sex SI duct include red testes. All the sperms after the formation of sperm, these sperms are collected by this part. This is called red testes. देन आफ्टर दे आर कलेक्टेड बाई द वॉसा इफ्रेंसिया नॉट डिफ्रेंसिया दिस इज दे आर कलेक्टेड बाई वॉसा दिस इज रेड टेस्टिस आफ्टर द रेड टेस्टिस दे आर स्पर्म्स आर कलेक्टेड बाई द वॉसा इफ्रेंसिया देन वॉसा इफ्रेंसिया आफ्टर द वॉसा इफ्रेंसिया स्पर्म्स आर कलेक्टेड बाई हाईली कॉइल्ड स्ट्रक्चर दिस इज कॉल्ड एपिडर्मिस देन आफ्टर वॉसा डिफ्रेंसिया द सेमिफेस्टिबुल्स ऑफ टेस्टिस ओपन इन टू द वॉसा इफ्रेंसिया राइट सो द स्पर्म्स आर फॉर्म इन द सेमिफेस्टिबुल्स देन आफ्टर दे आर कलेक्टेड बाई द रेड टेस्टिस दिस पार्ट इज कॉल्ड रेड टेस्टिस आफ्टर रेड टेस्टिस वॉसा इफ्रेंसिया कलेक्ट द स्पर्म आफ्टर द वॉसा इफ्रेंसिया दे इंटर इन साइड ऑफ द एपिडर्मिस द वॉसा इफ्रेंसिया लीव द टेस्टिस ओपन इन टू द एपिडर्मिस लोकेटेड अलोंग द पोस्टीरियर सर्फेस ऑफ इस टेस्टिस सो वॉसा आफ्टर द वॉसा इफ्रेंसिया स्पर्म्स इंटर इन साइड ऑफ द हाईली कॉइल्ड स्ट्रक्चर दिस इज कॉल्ड एपिडर्मिस इट इज सिचुएटेड ऑन द इट इज सिचुएटेड एट द पोस्टीरियर साइड ऑफ द इस टेस्टिस एपिडर्मिस लीड्स टू वॉसा डिफेंस एंड एसेंट टू द एब्डोमिनल लूप ओवर द यूरिनरी ब्लैडर राइट सो एपिडर्मिस इज सिचुएटेड इन साइड ऑफ द स्क्रोटम पार्ट बट एपिडर्मिस ट्रांसफर द स्पर्म इन वॉसा डिफरेंसिया सो वॉसा डिफरेंसिया इंटर इन साइड ऑफ द एब्डोमिनल कैविटी बाई द जेंस ऑफ इनगुइनल कैनाल एंड इट फॉर्म लूप ओवर द यूरिनरी ब्लैडर एंड द लेटर साइड ऑफ द यूरिनरी ब्लैडर इट फॉर्म लूप लाइक स्ट्रक्चर इन योर पोस्ट दिस इज यूरिनरी ब्लैडर दिस इज फॉर्मिंग लूप एंड दिस इज द स्टार्टिंग ऑफ एब्डोमिनल कैविटी राइट इट रिसीव इट डक्ट फ्रॉम द सेमल वेजिकल ओपन टू द यूरेथ्रा एज एस्कुलेटर सो दिस इज वॉसा डिफेंस एंड देयर इज ओपनिंग ऑफ सेमिनल वेजिकल बोथ आर कम्बाइंड वॉसा डिफेंस कम्बाइंड विद द ओपनिंग ऑफ सेमिनल वेजिकल एंड फॉर्म एजेकुलेटरी डक्ट इट ओपनड इन टू द यूरेथ्रा एज एजेकुलेटरी डक्ट दीज डक्ट्स स्टोर एंड ट्रांसपोर्ट द स्पर्म फ्रॉम टेस्टिस टू द आउटसाइड थ्रू यूरेथ्रा सो दीज डक्ट लाइक यूरेथ्रा स्टोर द स्पर्म्स एंड ट्रांसपोर्ट द स्पर्म्स फ्रॉम द टेस्टिस टू आउटसाइड थ्रू यूरेथ्रा यूरेथ्रा ओरिजिनेट फ्रॉम द यूरिनरी ब्लैडर एंड एक्सटेंड थ्रू द पेनिस टू इट्स एक्सटर्नल ओपनिंग कॉल्ड यूरेथ्रल मीटस सो यूरेथ्रा दिस इज यूरेथ्रा इट इज द स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट of the urinary bladder when it joined with the ejaculatory duct and this part is called urogenital tract so this urogenital tract opened outside by the urethral meatus so today I am completing my lecture at that point next lecture I will teach you next part okay thank you